Hey guys, back again. So this is a follow-on episode from the Broxton farm. So I'm in Hall Farm now, and basically, like I said at the end of the video, so this is just a first look. I'm looking to add another farm to this. You know, I've got Kendall Farm episodes that I'm doing on my own. I've got Thornton Farm episodes which I'm doing with my dad on multiplayer. And then I've got the Big Buds, which I'm doing on Sulvac Village. So it's alongside that. It's just, I'm not replacing anything. I just want to add to it. So basically what I want is, if you guys can like and subscribe. Sorry, I'm thinking I'm in the end of the video here. If you can like and comment on either this one, which is Hall Farm, or the Broxton Farm video. Like and comment on which one you prefer. So whichever one gets the most in a week or two, I'll then come back and do a series. So if you just let us know, it was more just to let you guys get involved and, you know, help me pick which farm. So I narrowed it down to these two. I've got to say, from just getting in it here, I like this farm layout. This is nice. Field layout, I haven't looked. So obviously it's quite small. The big map feels a bit useless, isn't it? We'll get rid of that. That's a downside. So we'll zoom in here. Right, so so this is going to be more like Kendall Farm, I think. But what I could do with this is the grass fields, you can see. Where we are? Yeah, the grass fields, like 9-6, you know, all them. I could just plow them and you know, make it into more of a different farm. But anyhow, so this is the main farm. So there, we've got some storage buildings here. So we've got a garage there which you can keep a car in or a van, workshop on the side. Then we've got this farm. Oh, can we open the gate please? So we've got another little building here. Keep the header. Oh no, it's quite a big building actually. Harvester in. Right, that's a really good flat area. I like that. Farm yard, this sort of yard has got a good feel to it. So, right, we'll go up here and jump the wall. So this is the other part. This will be where the cows are kept. Yeah, so cows in there, that's a feeding area, more storage, poo area, oh, more storage. I like a double gate, good gates these, we're going to open in the way or out the way. Right, so that's where the cows are. We've got a bit of a storage area there. I don't know if that's, is this storage or is this to do with the cows? I don't know, this is a big storage area around here. Oh, so the actual, this part of the farm actually is actually quite big. I was just thinking that it looks quite small, but can I just hop over here? I'm going to hop in this tractor. I'll steal this, cause I don't want to buy anything. I'll put a couple of mods in, like the ground mud mod. Just to get going. It's still got the auto starting that on, so that's the pit. Oh, I like that. That's a bunker. I've got a little case there. I've got a bit of forestry as well. Oh, I do like the odd bit of forestry. Not much, like, clear that in 10 minutes. So we'll go and have a drive around and see what the thoughts are. But if you want to see more crop stuff, I'm thinking maybe Broxton's a better farm. However, it does, oh, good bit of mud in the farm there. It doesn't have to be just, you know, I can do another, basically another dairy farm alongside Kendall, but I can also just plough the fields and make my own fields, which I do enjoy doing. Like this field here, with it not being flat, that's number 9. So I could plough the whole of this and then plant corn or something in it. Let us know. The whole point is to let people try and decide what they want to see. So I've detached, haven't I? Yes, I have. Cool. That a mud pit as well. Oh, I like that. So we can go along here to buy animals, I think. It's a very narrow lane, so definitely limited on smaller stuff, which is fine by myself. So I've got a house there. Oh, that's a sheep area. Some steep gardens. That'll take some cutting the grass on them. I love all the walls. Walls are really good. So this looks to be like a bit of a shop area. Nice pub. Stop there for Sunday lunch. Then we'll go up here. Is this where the cows? Oh yeah. So this is where you would purchase your animals. Nice little dead end there. So I mean, this looks a good size. The farm. The only thing is, as I say, it'll probably take a bit longer. It might be good with the seasons mod on, because if you want me to plough fields and that and take away the grass, which I would more than be happy to do, because I quite enjoy stuff like that, and we can change it into more of a different farm. So the only downside is, so we can go right here. There's not actually much roads on it. It is a very small map. I don't even know how we get to the shop. I'm assuming we go back down the way we come. It is actually a really small map, but that doesn't bother me at all. I don't mind. You see, I've got a couple of different series as well, but I think by looking around this, possibly Broxton's going to be a better... Can we get up here? Oh, I like this. Ah, this is cool. Come on. Oh, they put the mud right in the right place there. So this is... Oh, this is up back in the back of the farm. So it is... You're going to get around this farm very, very quickly. So Broxton is, in my opinion, probably a better farm on the size front. But I like the field shapes on this farm better. Definitely, they look more fun to, if I'm actually working on the fields, they look more fun to me anyway. So we're going to nip back down here. I love the way the farm feels. The actual farm itself feels really good. So we're going to go right this time. Loads of mud on the roads. Tractor's filthy. You can see the back of the farm there as well. I love how hilly this is. So we're going to drive out to the shop now, because pretty much you've seen all the fields. Loads of like nice farm tracks to drive down. I'm using a Land Rover or something to get about. I love all the concrete walls as well. All the stone walls, sorry, concrete. Yeah, but the stone built walls are nice. Somewhere to store your logs and that. So it looks like we're going... Are we going right here? Down a farm track to get to the shop. This is going to be interesting if you buy something big. But again, I could just use all old equipment on here if that's what you want to see. That's not that big a farm at all, really, that. So yeah, that's basically it. I'm going to see if I put any mods in, and with it being so small, we'll go and drive back down to the farm just to get a look out. I don't know if I put any. I've been using a couple of the in-game John Deere mods as well, so we've got the John Deere 6230R wheel setup, twin wheels, narrow wheels. I'll put the bigger engine in. Design pillar roof lights, B pillar roof lights. So we'll buy a couple of them for the farm. Just I actually just fancied a look at them because I've not actually bought them all. So wheel setup, narrow tyres, rear twins, standard. Well, I would say twins, even though I am a twin love person, I would say twins for this farm is probably going to be a bit much. So that was the 70-30 premium, and then we've got the 50-85. We don't need a load of attachment on that. Now get some new equipment into the shop. Just to have a quick nosy up. Ah, so the 50-85, this one here is probably going to be the best one because these ones are a bit bigger. Got a bit of a crackle. Sounds alright that. Oh, that sounds better. That's the 70-30 premium. And that's a little 50-85, so we'll take this back to the farm and get it muddy. This is probably about the correct size of tractor for this farm, but I could get a big tractor down here, no problem. I'm not saying that I would only use smaller stuff. Ah, it's grown on me the more I'm on this one as well, to be honest. I'm quite, no, it's nice. I'm quite enjoying it. It's very, very small. I say it's probably, I think possibly Broxton's going to get the vote because it's a bit different to what I'm doing, whereas this is a bit like Kendall with it being field orientated. But as I say, don't forget, if you do vote for this one and you want me to plough the fields and we'll put crops in them instead, just to change things up a bit, that's, you know, I'm up for that. Are we up here? Yeah. We'll go and park in this part of the farm. Right, cool. So that was a quick look around Hall Farm. As I say, I can put seasons in and so forth. You know, I can put different things in. Comes with a little skid steer as well. But yeah, just let us know in the comments what do you want to see, what type of farm do you want to see. You know what? Ideally, I'd prefer to vote just between Hall Farm and Broxton. That's what I want to know. I've played Sandy Bay and things like that, but I'm more than happy if that's what you want to see. I'll play them as well. But no, just either vote on this one and let me know if you want to see Hall Farm, or vote on the Broxton Farm video and leave a comment or a like. Whichever one's got more likes or comments or whatever, that's the one I'll do, and I'll probably come back to it in about 2 weeks and see which one's got more likes and comments. So again, let me know what you think. Like, subscribe for more content, there's loads more coming. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Take care.